Joining us on the line is Shirley Sir. I'm going to pronounce your name wrong. How do you pronounce your last name?
Officially Sherban.
Sherban. Because you have the S with the, I feel so ignorant, with a little thing on the bottom.
It's called a cedilla.
A cedilla.
And it's something I didn't know about until a few years ago. It's a surname I've inherited by marrying exotically.
I see. Okay. All right. So you are in New Zealand, yes?
I am.
Yes. What part of New Zealand?
On the South Island, for those of you who know Lord of the Rings, a lot of the mountains in Lord of the Rings I can see very close to my home. So in the South Island, near the mountains, basically, on the West Coast.
Okay. Well, I'm sure it's beautiful there. I'm in South Florida in the U.S.
So a little bit different to here.
A little bit different, right? But we're all in sort of the same boat right now, dealing with this coronavirus and staying at home. What is it like where you live? What are the orders? Are you ordered to stay at home? What's happening there?
Yeah, we're we've got four levels that were introduced to us as a country, and so we're currently in the highest one, level four, which basically means stay at home. You can only go out for essential services or if you're an essential worker. So we're allowed to go out to do essential shopping, which is really just groceries, pharmacies, that kind of thing, doctor's appointments. And people who work in those services, they can work. Otherwise, we're meant to stay indoors. We're allowed to walk around our local area for exercise. I'm very lucky because I live by a lake. Mm. And so we can go for a walk and be in beautiful nature within 5 minutes. But yeah, we're not allowed to drive for fun. We're not allowed to go further afield. We're not allowed to visit anyone who doesn't live in the same house with us.
Wow.
They're reviewing that tomorrow.
So we'll see.
And if it does lessen tomorrow, there'll be a little bit more leeway, but it will still be quite tight.
It is astounding what we've all been doing around the globe, you know, separately, but together. And so many of us have gotten very creative. Now, I discovered you, Shirley, on YouTube, I'm sure, as millions of others have. You have produced some of the most amazing videos, song parodies, all centered around COVID-19 and this quarantine time. What made you start doing these?
You know, it wasn't a planned thing at all. I've got a job that requires a lot of thinking during this time. I'm the principal of a small school.
Yeah, I saw that.
And so as we were leading up towards the lockdown, it all came very quickly. And so, you know, within less than half of a week, we were going from normal but nervous and trying to keep our distance to everyone being staying at home. And so the first Saturday of the lockdown, I knew that I needed to do something to get my mind off school, because otherwise you'll just keep thinking and working. And I knew I needed a mental break as well. And I've written songs on the side for years. I had been writing a song with lyrics based on Do Re Mi just the previous week anyway for a private client.
Right.
And one thing led to the other. Corona was on my mind. The Sound of Music was on my mind. And I needed to do something. My normal go-to, if I really need to relax and the weather's good, will be going for a kayak. Because like I said, I live on a lake, but we're not allowed to do that. So stuck inside, what do you do? So may as well write the song. And I did. And yeah, I did it purely for my own entertainment and just to de-stress myself. And I liked how it turned out. I only used the backing video because I was watching it to see how the harmony parts worked. And And as I sang the song while watching the video, I thought, oh, they kind of fit quite fun together.
So
I did it that way, showed a couple of friends, shared it with one or two groups of educators on Facebook, and then it kind of went nuts from there. I've sort of been sitting back laughing and been quite bemused at how this has spread far more than I expected.
Well, we've all been laughing too, thanks to you. And because this is a time when we need, you know, we're looking for entertainment and we want things that make us laugh. And I've been searching for my show. I try to start the program every day with a humorous video, a comedy bit, something, because I say we need to laugh now because things are going to get serious down the road. And I stumbled upon The Sound of Music. You did a couple of those, and then you branched out and did a couple of Wizard of Oz videos as well.
Yeah, I was so surprised by the amount of positive feedback that I had from the video, and a bunch of people commenting as well as contacting me privately, just to say that it really had cheered them up. And I thought, well, you know, I feel I've got my immediate work I need to do, continue from home. But if I can do anything to help people stay happy and smile a little bit without diminishing how important this whole situation is.
Right.
why not? I've got the time. It helps me relax and it helps other people too. So it's a win-win all around as far as I'm concerned.
So you did these videos, so those were using the film, but you've done some on your own. You did one, and of course I don't have it in front of me. But...
I've done a takeoff of Sinead O'Connor's Nothing Compares to You.
Okay.
I've done Mr. Sandman. That
That's
old
the one.
One.
Mr. Sandman was the one I played the other day.
Yeah, Neil Sedaka's uh-huh. Breaking Up Is Hard to Do.
Uh-huh.
I just put out yesterday a cover of the Oompa Loompas song. From
I
the
thought. It's wonderful.
Shot in the Chocolate Factory. Yeah, and I've got about 7 other ideas in my head that I'm working through. I'm trying not to do them all at once, just because I need to pay for myself as well.
Your profession, you said earlier, you're the principal of a small school. You're not a professional singer. You've got a wonderful voice, and the harmonies okay. you're doing are incredible.
Thank you. I've been singing longer than I've been teaching, but I do it for entertainment. Yeah.
And then I go to your website, which is shirleycan.com, and you're a photographer. But you write that that's not your full-time job, because your full-time job is a principal of a school.
All these other things are creative outlets for me. And if I don't exercise my creative juices, as I'm sure many people would be, mm-hmm. It's not good for me. And so photography is something I've always enjoyed, singing something I've always enjoyed, creating music, writing, all that. And yeah, if I can help people at the same time, great.
Oh, it's wonderful. And so here we are connecting across the world. We're talking, it's now Saturday night here in South Florida at 9:07 p.m. It's Sunday afternoon there?
It is. Yep. Yep, and you've got a rainy day to look forward to.
Ah, yeah. Good to know. Can you tell me what's going on? Oh, it's Sunday, so there's no stock market or anything happening. Just wondering if our dear leader is going to say anything really stupid tomorrow. But I guess you don't even have to be in the future to figure that out, because we know what the answer is.
Reserve comment.
I'm sorry?
I'll reserve comment on that one.
Okay. So how you have a wonderful young prime minister in New Zealand. Yes. How's she doing?
Yes. Jacinda Ardern, you know, I think despite what people think of the party politics, because you're always going to get back and forth with that, she has been praised by people on all sides for just how well she's handled this as a leader. One thing I really like is that she appears very approachable. She wants, well, gives the impression that she really wants to communicate what she knows to us. We are very much all in this together. And I remember she did a live Facebook live video, and she was in her sweatshirt hoodie sitting in her room, and she just fed her daughter and, you know, was saying, oh, sorry if there's noises nearby, or stains down her top. So very relatable person. And, you know, this is not an easy situation for anybody to be in, but no. I really admire Jacinda Ardern for how she's leading us.
So she's doing a good job. I wish I could say the same here. Unfortunately, things are not so good. I have to ask you this, because I've connected with people in other countries as we're going through this quarantine period. I call it quarantine calling. I spoke with someone in Finland the other day, someone in Denmark, someone in Italy, someone in New South Wales, Australia, and now you in New Zealand. What happens if you get sick or you start getting symptoms, you feel like you need a test for COVID? How easy is it to get tested, and what's the procedure? What do you have to do in order to get medical care?
You know, I haven't got the symptoms yet myself, so I haven't looked too deeply into it, but I do know that there are testing centers all over the place. For people who live more rurally, it will involve more of a drive, but for traveling to get a test, that would be counted as essential travel, so that's no issue. I know in Greymouth, which is our nearest town center, that's a half hour drive away, I know where the testing center is, and as far as I know, it's just a matter of turning up if you've got the symptoms, but you're meant to ring your GP first and get advice from them. But yeah, like I said, I haven't had to do it. Right. I don't know anyone who has.
That's good.
We've only got two active cases on the West Coast that I know of. Yeah, it's too many, of course. And sure. through the country, I think we've got far lower numbers than many countries do. But yeah, we want to keep it that way, of course. And I think in the beginning, we were looking at containing it and slow down that curve so the hospitals can cope. I think the talk is much more now about let's get rid of it in New Zealand and then be very careful with our borders that it doesn't come back in. Yeah, how possible that is, I don't know.
Is there any pushback? I mean, over here right now, all of a sudden in cities around the country, there are these protests popping up, egged on by right-wing conservative media, and they're saying, liberate, you know, whoever, and they want the lockdown ended, but we don't even have widespread testing over here. That's why I asked about testing. If you feel like you need a test, you get a test, right?
Oh, I can get one. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. That's still not the case here. And then there's the question of billing. What does it cost when you go to the doctor?
Well, it depends which one you go to. The last time I went was, I think it was 18 New Zealand dollars, which is maybe 10 US, something like that. In New Zealand, we have a different system, of course, than the States.
Yes, everybody does.
Anything that happens accidentally, whether you're a New Zealand born resident or even visitor, we're covered by accident compensation, which basically means taking out suing completely. And you get free medical care for the results of that accident for as long as it's needed.
As it should be.
Do
you need health insurance? I mean, if you get sick, if you get cancer, or if you get COVID-19, or is there any worries about how you're going to pay for treatment?
No, not at all. No, if you're here, you'll be taken care of. A lot of people do have private health insurance, but it's not something that you have to have. I've had people in my immediate family whose lives have been saved multiple times through the public system and not paid a cent.
Wow. And do you feel that you're...
I've had long-term care, yeah. Sorry?
Do you have long-term care, you just said?
Yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah, it covers the immediate, you know, hospital stay, the treatment, surgery, as well as, you know, ongoing things like radiation or follow-up visits, physiotherapy, all that sort of thing.
Right.
Yep.
And it's all included. And it's paid through your taxes, basically. Do you feel like your taxes are prohibitively high?
Nope. No, well, when you pay them and you know what they're going for.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, I mean, I'm not representative of all the views in New Zealand, of course.
Sure.
But I happen to really like it. Yeah.
It sounds wonderful. I'm very envious because, you know, there's a real problem over here with a lot of people who've been still go to work with symptoms because, number one, they can't afford not to because they don't go to work. They don't get paid. It's insane.
Sure.
And then
it's a difficult choice, I guess, for politicians to make, that you weigh up the cost of caring for someone extensively, and will that outweigh the longer term cost to the economy and to the country? And I think that the stance in New Zealand, as well as many other countries, I suppose like Scandinavia as well, they prefer to pay more to take care of people initially so that there's less cost long term.
Well, that's what makes sense. Unfortunately, we have a for-profit healthcare system over here, which is totally insane. I mean, so much of what goes on here is insane. I've been telling people who I speak to around the world that I apologize for the stuff coming out of Washington, D.C. these days. Most of us did not vote for him, and we're hoping that this November we can change things. I with everything in me, I want nothing more.
I just hope that in November we can be back to sitting in cafes with one another.
You and me both.
And children playing in the playground at school together without worry of these things. But, you know, it's interesting, the long-term plans that we all have seem quite irrelevant now in some ways, don't they?
Absolutely.
I've never been more day-to-day in my thinking than I am now. And learning to be okay with that, because we have to be.
Right.
But you realize what's important as well, you know, the immediate relationships, the things that really matter, right?
Most definitely. And reaching out to people across the world, because I think that's important. This just shows what a small world it truly is. So
there's a new song I should take off. Yeah.
There you, oh, absolutely. Please do, because I was going to use that, you know, music for a theme for this segment that I do, but it really is. The world's getting smaller and smaller. And Shirley, absolutely. I thank you so much for the great enjoyment you've given us. You're incredibly talented. I hope the students at your school get to share some of this great talent you're sharing with the rest of us.
I'd just like to see them again.
I'll bet. Shirley, thank you so much for spending a few minutes with us. I really appreciate it. And I love your videos, as do my listeners.
Thank you very much. You have a good evening.
Thank you. You have a wonderful day.